Hello and welcome to today's video. Today we'll be discussing a numerical subjective stability on the topic of loading unloading cargo on ships and how that will affect the movement of center of gravity. Now, when we deal with a ship's stability, something which always needs to be looked upon is the position of center of mass, center of gravity of your ship at each and every point of time. When the ship is being loaded, unloaded, or when the ship is on the voyage, there will be certain movement of mass on board, or there will be some shifting of mass or adding or discharging, loading or unloading of mass. So each and every movement, addition or removal of mass will affect the actual position of center of gravity of the vessel. And where does the position of center of gravity of a ship lie? Within the vertical plane as well as the horizontal plane. Okay, that means if we take the vertical axis as well as the longitudinal axis, the position of center of gravity, where it lies with respect to metacenter, with respect to center of buoyancy, with respect to your center of flotation, with respect to midship, all these things, all this data is very important for us in calculation about ship stability. See, the main purpose of subject ship stability is we need to have the vessel react in a controlled manner to any external or internal disturbances happening on the vessel and its motions. So the movement, the motions of the ship should be within our control. So for that we need to have a method of prediction. We need to be able to predict how will a vessel behave, how will more likely it is to sink or remain afloat. To answer these questions, we need to know the position of center of gravity at each and every juncture. So today we'll be discussing a numerical in which we have a various examples of loading unloading being done. As we all know, usually the loading unloading happens in a port. So how this will affect the ship's position of center of gravity, that is what we will try to explore today in this video. So let us start with the question. A ship arrives in port with a kg of 6.8 meters and a displacement of 6080 tons. While in the port, she discharges and loads the following cargo. Now discharge 1250 tons from 5 meters above the keel, 675 tons from 3.5 meters above the keel, 30 tons from 0.7 meters above the keel, and loads 980 tons at 3.2 meters above the keel, 550 tons at 0.6 meter above keel, 700 tons at 0.6 meter above keel, 70 tons at 11 meter above keel. She then sails. After loading and unloading, she then sails, and in that process she burns 840 tons of oil from 0.6 meters above the keel and 60 tons of water from 11 meters above the keel. Find the kg at the beginning and end of voyage, assuming there is no free surface. So this is the question in front of us. This is a typical situation we would encounter when a ship is in the port and in the process of loading and unloading. So if I can spend little time in this question, let us look at the data. We have a ship in the port. The center of gravity, initial center of gravity position, is given to be at 6.8 meters. K is the keel. 6.8 meters is the initial center of gravity. And the displacement, the mass displacement of the vessel in the initial condition is given. And as what happens in a port, there is a series of loading and unloading. She discharges these many cargo, and see how the data is presented to us. The cargo is removed from the position. The position is given with respect to keel. Okay, so we the data is very much ready-made for us as far as calculation of moments is concerned with respect to keel. All the that is for simplification given with respect to keel. this much cargo is removed from this much distance from the keel, this much cargo is added from this much distance from the keel. So this data is given, okay, and after which our ship sails, and during sailing, you know, there is a burning of bunkers and water is used up, you know. So that is also given. 840 tons of oil is burnt, and the position of that oil, the tank, the oil tank is given, the fuel oil tank is given, and 60 tons of fresh water is consumed, and the position of that tank is also given. So in simple words, we have some places weight is being added, some places weight is being removed, and some places substances are being consumed because of which weight is being removed. So after all these things, we need to find out the new center of gravity position. So that is how the question is given to us. Now if I can just put this question in the form of a diagram, you know, in a ship we have various masses at different places, you know, on the deck or below the deck we'll have loading of cargo, then we'll have fuel, fresh water, or maybe other things. And each time when we add or you know, remove these masses, your KGM, K is the keel, M is the metacenter, G is the center of gravity. So K is constant keel, M is constant up to a certain angle of heel, but G, center of gravity, will definitely change, as you can see, when you add or remove mass. In the vertical as well as in the longitudinal plane, your center of gravity position will change. But in this question, we will only consider the vertical change. We will not consider the longitudinal change because that data is not given. All the mass, the position of masses is given with respect to keel. So, we will consider only the vertical position. So, how do we solve this question? Now, we need to calculate the moments of statical stability. So, I am given here a table. This table is actually a tabular form of the data given in the question. So you can see this is the initial displacement of the vessel, the initial kg of the vessel, and I am calculating moment about keel, because this distance is the position of that mass with respect to keel. So I am calculating the moment with respect to keel. So each and every, you can see the statement given in the question, I have given correspondingly. Discharging means it is removal of mass, that is why minus sign has come, and loading means here also it is discharge, not loading, discharging. So again, it's, since it's discharge, it is minus 30, and all other places where loading is happening, okay, please neglect this. This is not loading, this is discharging. So this is discharging, that is why negative sign. So wherever loading is there, positive sign, wherever discharge is there, negative sign. And finally, you can see she burns oil, she uses water. So there also it is removal of mass. So that is why I am using negative sign. So now I am calculating the moments. If I take the moments, I take the values, that is weight into the kg, the distance. So I will get the moment. Now I add the moment. So sum of moments is sigma 2, sum of weights is sigma 1. Now I apply the formula. The new kg is sigma 2 by sigma 1. So the sigma 2, the value I have got, the sigma 1 I have got, I substitute and I will get, this is the new position of center of gravity. Initially it was 6.8, now you can see at the end of the all this process there is an addition of mass. So that is why you can see, because the mass has been added, you can see the kg position here has actually gone up, the g has gone up. And one of the reasons can be because the addition of mass has happened more above the position of center of gravity. That can be one reason. So this is the final answer as required in the question. I hope you have understood how these calculations are done. If you have any doubts, please you can get back to me in my email ID promote.imu@gmail.com. Thank you very much for listening.